Funny guy. He always had a new joke or a story to tell you every time you saw him. Most of the time, several. Indeed, he made it a point to try and get us to laugh during the concerts while we were playing. If you observe some of the woodwinds doing some choreography during some of the pieces, that was Dennis's choreography. Well, the next piece, which we're about to perform for you, has some particular significance with regards to Dennis and his jokes and his choreography, which I'll tell you in a moment. But first, let me tell you just a bit about the piece. Descriptive overtures like The Death of Custer, which we're going to play for you, were highly popular for a period of time around the turn of the century. These programmatic pieces depicted their storylines in highly graphic musical images. Although musical tastes and sensitivity to native cultures have changed considerably, thank goodness, in our own time, such pieces offer performers and listeners alike an opportunity for musical fun and also a glance back to the culture of an earlier time when works of this type could hold an audience to the edge of its seats. Composer Lee Johnson provided the following program for The Death of Custer. Part 1, Sioux Indian War Dance, Night Before the Battle. Part 2, Bugle Calls in Custer's Camp Before Forming the Line of March. Part 3, Custer's Cavalry on March to Sioux's Camp, the sound of horses' hoofs in the distance. Part 4, Approach of the Cavalry with band playing national airs, the Indians responding with their customary war music. Part 5, Battle of the Little Big Horn, June 25th, 1876, in which our general lost his life. Part 6, Indians rejoicing over the victory. Part 7, Arrival of reinforcements, General Benteen and cavalry. Part 8, Custer's burial, muffled drums and bugles sounding the last call over our general's grave. And a finale, Near My God to Thee. Now, when the Advocate Band played this piece many years ago, I played piccolo next to Dennis right here. And knowing the kind of joker he was, I foolishly double-dared him to stand up during the Indian whoops that are called for in the piece and turn around while whooping. Well, I should have known he was going to do it. So during the concert, and you'll know the section I'm talking about when you hear it, Dennis stuck a feather in his long ponytail, stood up, and began turning around making whooping sounds. Well, you should have seen the look of shock and dismay on director George Foreman's face. We were laughing so hard, I don't know how we got through the rest of the piece. So this is The Death of Custer, and we hope that you enjoyed as much as we did that day many years ago. Thank you.
Thank you.